I'm surprised they didn't put plates down in the car.
Oh, that goes all the way down.
Columbia and Augusta. That crossing is officially called Huggers. And we see about one car a year on it. In good years, too. This is a pretty good sized farm, about 725 acres. They have three crops, hay, corn, and sunflowers. And sunflowers near us here. They are not in bloom, as you can tell. They will be within about a week, maybe two, and they last only 2 weeks. So we will have a spectacular field of yellow, and later on the other side of the train as well, sunflowers come into bloom. Across the highway on the left is the farmstead, big white home, built in 1912, and it has a absolutely spectacular stand of hardwood trees around it, big old mature trees. It's quite a setting. That house could be, I guess, on the National Register of Historic Places. It is not. But it certainly has the history. South Carolina. Passengers, if there were more than two, would have to be awfully good friends. Have you looked at the phone line? Did you figure out that it doesn't go anywhere? Now, put together corn, sunflowers, a phone line out there. Can you come up with doves? They do dove hunting out here. I've seen in the fall as many as 20 hunters all hiding behind hay bales out there in the field, all shooting in the same direction. And they have a big dove hunt here. Across the highway is another one of the not restored in any way, sharecropper's cabins. Notice there are two fireplaces on a diagonal on our side of the chimney, and on the back side of the chimney is the kitchen fireplace. That was a very common arrangement. That one's not going to last for another year or two. Now this is a larger than standard sharecropper's cabin, and the chimney, instead of being in the middle, is on one end.
Yeah.
stops and starts. The next three cars are apartment cars. First one has one big apartment that occupies half the car, and then two smaller apartments on the rest of the car. We guessed that the large apartment was either the trainmaster or the ringmaster. Then the next car has five apartments, and the last one has 11. You think, man, they gotta be small. Yes, they are. These folks, remember, lived on the train for 9 months during the performance of the circus. They are very comfortable, although small, eating, air conditioning, running water, cooking, nice beds, places to sit, showers, toilets, you name it, washing machine. We have yet to put all of his stories together. You can see into the airport right here on the right. Those of you on the left, the right side can't see it, look under the second car, down at the bottom, under the car. There is white lettering on black tanks, under the second car, way down. Read the words. Doniker, pump house, water tank. Well, everybody knows what a water tank is, right? Everybody knows what a pump is, right? What's a Doniker? I have had one person ever tell me that they knew that a Doniker was the word for toilet on circus parlance. Okay, now, popping out at the end of the train here is going to be the Greenbrier School. Greenbrier School, built in 1941, went out of business as a school in the 1970s. South Carolina took 17 years to discover that Brown versus the Board of Education had been ordered. That school is Winnsboro, Blue Granite. It had grades 1 through 11 when it was built. The main building has a long corridor down the middle, classrooms on both sides. The building on the left is the gymnasium, and the building on the right is the auditorium. It's in a private ownership now. He has an apartment here on the right. His curtains are not up today. But his apartment is on the right, and he has a small factory in there that makes tuning pegs for various stringed instruments. The company's name that bought the thing was Martin Marietta, that my brain wouldn't produce. Martin Marietta Aggregates owns the quarries now. That's granite. Now, is that Winnsboro Blue Granite or Winnsboro Granite? The answer is yes. I believe it's the ordinary granite, not the blue. I have trouble telling the two colors apart. We're going to stop in here for a brief lesson on quarrying.
One more problem.
This was not here last week. This all
came up and was talking.
Wow.
Notice some of the rocks over on the left are broken up.
When water gets into a crack in the rock and freezes, water expands when it freezes and it breaks up rocks. And so that's how over the centuries, millennia, that those rocks got broken up. And what you were seeing is the same rock that you saw in the cut. That is bedrock granite. And the reason it shows right there is because Mother Nature over time has beat down the woods until the rock shows. A tank car. cars.
Yeah, there's old top rock. That's some tight quarters. I guess that's the bedroom. And it also has a bathroom in it. Oh, wow. That's a bunk bed. So far, this is the biggest area.
Yeah.
would have been the mail room. And apparently somebody got mad because they couldn't get their mail, so they knocked the windows out. And that's another bathroom right there. And this would have been the luggage. I do like how they got ceiling fans also, because it was hot in here. And right there's the end of train device. That's what you see flashing. Oh my god, they even got a desk in here. Almost like the ones whenever I went to school, but I'm not quite that old, but they're somewhat similar. So this will be the train that we just walked through. They've got it set up as if it's on the track. This is number 44, engine number 44. And I'm getting ready to walk all the way down as long as people don't get in it. Because, you know, I know a lot of people don't like to be videoed. I don't know what that right there is for. Maybe that's for livestock, since it's definitely open air. And then right here's where I got off a while ago. When that shows, that was the United States Mail Railway Post Office. And that over there is where I got on at.